John chapter 4, verse 23 and 24. But the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshippers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. I speak quickly on the subject, the pursuit of God. In life today, there are various objects of pursuit. We see people in the world today, and they tell you, all I want to make is money. Just money. I want to make as much money as I can make. There are those who pursue money. These people can kill to get money. Turn into ritual killers, turn into armed robbers, turn into hired assassins, turn into kidnappers. Many don't even care about going to God or going to church. Then there are those who are in pursuit of power. Some occultic power, so they can do anything to get at the power. Some political power. They can get to every extent to get at political power, as we see in our nation today, where we have a most shameful display of the political process since I grew up as a person. It looks like a set of hooligans who want to use other hooligans to get into power by all means. Area men. You know area boys in Lagos? To the detriment of Jehovah God. You have grown up for a while in this country. I don't know the first time you heard of election. This state suspended. This state suspended. This one inconclusive. This one inconclusive. This one inconclusive. This one suspended. This one since you were born. This man is a young man. He said this is the first time. Hello? Where people in uniform are struggling with ballot box with people. I watched a video where some women say, no, you will not steal our ballot box. Where people are giving gun to protect people and using the same gun to terrorize those they are paid to protect. The people's taxpayer, the taxpayer's money paid them. They're using them to terrorize the same people. Hooligans and street people. Half insane people. Looking for power at all cost. But there is a God on the throne in heaven. Let everybody who knows God know that we have not had the end of the matter yet, as far as this country is concerned. have not heard the end of the matter. There is no level of show of force that can set the nation permanently into cowardice. No level. No level. There are those who pursue materialistic things. But the best pursuit on earth is the pursuit of God. What does the pursuit of God do for you? Number one, to pursue God is to be pursued by God. When you pursue God, you end up being pursued by God. The hour cometh and now is, for the Father seeketh. You start the pursuit, and you end up being pursued. You start the pursuit, and you end up being pursued. Until people begin to wonder, what did this man, what did this girl, what did this person do for God that God has so lavishly favored him? Somebody told me the other day, he said, what do you want to leave for others? You are doing this and you can do this and you can do that. And in my heart, the answer is the pursuit of God. David pursued God until God so pursued him. He was a psalmist. He was a singer. He was a songwriter. He was a dancer. He was a warrior. He was a king. He was a priest. He was a prophet. One man. God called him the man after my heart. To pursue God is to be pursued by God. Number two, to pursue God is to access your portion with God. You access your portion with God. He says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. To pursue God is to access your portion with God. Number three, to pursue God is to be protected by God. It's to be protected by God. Job was called the man who was upright, who feared God, who eschewed evil, who pursued God in every realm. And that Job, in Job chapter 1 verse 10, had a hedge around him. When you are a pursuer of God, you cannot be successfully pursued by any witch, by any wicked agent under heaven. You can't be pursuing God and the devil be pursuing you at the same time. In Genesis chapter 35, verse 5. The Bible says, Jacob and his family journeyed, and the terror of God was upon the cities that were round about them. If you remember, Jacob is the one who said, I won't let you go until you bless me. And they did not pursue after the sons of Jacob. Not everybody is pursuable by the devil. 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 To pursue God is to be pursued by God. To pursue God is to access your portion in God. And to pursue God is to be protected by God. How is the pursuit of God expressed? Number one, by desperate passion for God. How do you express your pursuit of God? By a passion for God that cannot die. Desperate passion for God. Desperate passion for God. How do you express your pursuit of God? Number two. By dedicated praise to God. Desperate passion, dedicated praise. Dedicated praise. A life of worship. Your passion expressed in praise. And thirdly, by devotion to his principles. You are desperate in your passion. You are dedicated in praise. And you are devoted to his principles. What he wants you to do, you do. And when that happens, you are set. What God wants to do for somebody this morning is far beyond healing. It's far beyond deliverance. He wants to drop on you himself. His presence. And if there are those who today will say, Lord, I am hungry for you. 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 Then that hunger will produce result now. It's emotion. Anybody hungry for God this morning? Anybody want your hunger for God to move to another level this morning? Then stand up on your feet. Stand up on your feet. Stand up on your feet. Every one of you, stand up on your feet. You want your hunger for God to move to another level this morning? Lift up your hands everywhere you are. Shatoko pakatakalaka prakatakalaka. Be upstanding.
Draw me, Lord. I come running after you. Draw me, Lord. I come running after you.